The Xperia XZ2 is Sony's first flagship phone of 2018. It sports a snazzy new design that really shakes things up. But is it a worthy successor to last year's XZ1? Well, it definitely offers quite a few surprises, and here's our full in-depth review. And if you want in-depth features and reviews of the latest, sexiest smartphones and other top tech, then don't forget to give us a like and a subscribe. Cheers.
The most immediate change over the Xperia XZ1 is obvious from the moment you clap eyes on this shiny beast. Sony Mobile has completely overhauled its smartphone design language, offering a mostly glass finish with much skinnier bezels above and below the display. Despite that slenderness around, the Xperia XZ2 is still a bit of a handful, and that's thanks to the enlarged 5.7-inch display, which is only beaten by Sony's Ultra phones in terms of screen size. Thankfully, you do at least get a one-handed mode to help out in a pinch. Absolutely everything about this handset's design screams premium. While the infinity display finish of the Samsung Galaxy S9 might be more technically impressive, the XZ2 is similarly striking thanks to that deliciously curvy rear plate and the gorgeous colour options.
The XZ2 also has quite a heft to it at 200 grams, you'll certainly feel it when it's stashed inside your shorts, and at almost 12mm thick, it ain't no skinny mini either, but thankfully it is IP67 water resistant, so at least you can give it a good old dunking with no repercussions.
Another part of that design shakeup is the fingerprint sensor, which has moved from its traditional spot around the right hand edge around to the rear of the phone instead. That circular scanner is certainly responsive, unlocking the XZ2 in the blink of an eye, and likewise it only seems to feel when your fingers are wet or sticky. However, for whatever reason, Sony has positioned that sensor almost completely centrally rather than up towards the top end of the phone where your fingertip naturally falls. At first it took some serious getting used to, and I was constantly tapping that camera lens instead of the sensor, thinking that that was the right thing. And of course that kinda got old real fast.
Thankfully, a few days of using the Xperia XZ2 has kind of corrected the issue, although it still isn't the most comfortable solution that we have used. And also note that the XZ2 doesn't sport any form of facial recognition, unlike some rivals such as the OnePlus 5T and the Huawei P20 Pro.
Android Oreo is the OS of choice, with plenty of Sony smart features slathered on top like a beautifully sweet layer of jam spread on a nicely toasted bit of bread. Customization remains a really strong point. You can configure pretty much every aspect of your Xperia XZ2 software, from the general theme right down to the icon design and even the desktop grid size. Likewise, you can play around with several display and audio settings to get them just to your liking. And if you're new to Xperia smartphones or even Android in general, Sony has you covered with the Xperia Assist feature. This offers all kinds of helpful advice, features and support, and it comes complete with a snazzy new conversational style. This helps to get you started with the Xperia XZ2, showing you all the basics and also some of the more useful features that are packed away inside. Also new is the dynamic vibration system, which adds a rumble effect when you're watching video. This can be activated in the likes of Netflix and YouTube, and it works reasonably well considering it's first gen and it's a reactive feature. At first it can be a little bit distracting, but we found that it basically reacted just to the video soundtrack rather than what was actually happening on screen.
All the same, it does kind of add a new layer of interactivity to your video watching, and we can't really fault Sony for trying something a bit more original, and who knows, maybe in its second or third generation it'll be a really sweet feature.
And fan favourites such as the PS4 Remote Play feature are also present and correct, rounding off a very solid package. For more information on that and all of the other favourite features packed away in there, check out our full Xperia XZ2 tips and tricks, guys.
Now, the Xperia XZ2 sports the biggest smartphone display of any of its previous flagship handsets.
That 5.7-inch tri-luminous panel is an absolute beauty, boasting HDR support and the ability to upscale lower quality video. It's also the first Sony phone to rock a stretched 18:9 aspect ratio thanks to those slender top and bottom bezels. If you're a movie fan, that's really good news, as the reduced letterboxing effect means you'll get a much better view of the action, while that Full HD Plus resolution keeps images nice and crisp. And of course, you can always tinker with the display output as well to get it just the way you like it. So for instance, if you dive into the color gamut and contrast section, right in there you've got your standard mode set by default, but you can jump up to the super vivid mode if you prefer more vibrant, kick-ass visuals. Or if you prefer more realistic color reproduction, try the professional mode, which uses the sRGB color gamut. And audio quality via those dual front-facing speakers is perfectly fine for a smartphone, although you will want to connect some headphones or a speaker to enjoy any music. Thankfully, you can do without for simply watching a bit of YouTube, and even in a noisy outside environment, I had absolutely no problems whatsoever with clarity.
However, Sony has unfortunately ditched the headphone port from the edge of the phone, just like many of its rivals such as Huawei and Apple, which means that if you do want to use a wired pair, you're going to have to use the bundled USB to 3.5mm jack adapter.
Got a massive media collection to carry around with you? Well, the good news is that Sony Xperia XZ2 packs in 64 gigs of space, although that does fill up surprisingly fast. Luckily, it also supports microSD memory cards of up to 400 gigs, so you can expand it quickly and easily.
The Xperia XZ2 is a pioneer in many respects, and just one of the reasons is the chipset that's stuffed inside that shiny shell. Qualcomm's Snapdragon 845 was just launched at the end of 2017, and the XZ2 marks its first appearance in the UK.
So far, we have absolutely no complaints whatsoever. Android Oreo runs like a dream. Apps load up the instant you tap them without any kind of delay at all. And games also play without any kind of lag or dropped frames, so you can keep your thumbs busy on those long trips.
However, one of the biggest new features of the 845, which Qualcomm was very keen to point out, is its energy efficiency, which is apparently a massive jump over the older 835. Which meant that we were expecting some really great things from the Sony Xperia XZ2's 3180mAh battery.
Well, the good news is that the phone will last a long day on a single charge, even with quite regular and intensive use. It's a little bit better than Samsung's Galaxy S9, although Sony's own Xperia XZ2 does offer better performance for less cash. Still, that smart Qnova tech is in place to keep the phone from overcharging, which could lead to long-term damage. And you also have Quick Charge 3.0 support, plus support for wireless charging, thanks to that snazzy glass design.
So far, for us at least, the Sony Xperia XZ2 has delivered on pretty much every front, offering a satisfying and slightly seductive everyday experience. However, it's that rear-mounted camera tech that really gets our undercrackers stirring.
Slapped on the back of that phone is a 19-megapixel motion eye camera of Sony's own design. Sure, Huawei's new P20 Pro boasts 3 times the number of lenses, but quantity isn't directly linked to quality. And while the megapixel count hasn't changed over last year's Xperia XZ1, the XZ2 packs a lot more camera smarts. For one, it can now shoot HDR video at up to 4K resolution, and the super slow motion feature has also been boosted, so you can now shoot in up to full HD rather than 720p like many of its rivals.
However, what really impresses us is just the basic everyday photo capture. You get some really impressive results even when you just stick with the auto mode. Go check out our full Sony Xperia XZ2 camera review if you want to see your photo and video samples and hear our in-depth thoughts. Sony's first flagship phone of 2018 serves up a fresh new design, as well as refining the overall user experience. It doesn't care if it's a bit chunkier and heavier than some of its rivals, it just concentrates on getting the basics right, serving up a great media experience and one of the best smartphone cameras that we've had the pleasure of testing. Cheers for watching everyone, don't forget to give us a like and a subscribe and ding that notifications bell if you want to hear more about the latest top tech. You have yourselves a lovely day.